In the sixth round of the 2021 NFL Draft, the Eagles selecting defensive lineman Marlon Tuipulotu. I'm Eagles insider Dave Spadaro, and I'm glad to have him with me. And I got the name right. Did I not get the name correct, Marlon?
That was perfect, Dave.
Thank you, man. And we did practice that before we went on the air here. We've had some time here since the draft, Marlon, to digest the idea of being a Philadelphia Eagle. Has it all sunk in, settled in, and you feeling good about things?
Oh, yeah, I'm feeling real good. I'm excited to get up there to Philly next week. So I'm just blessed right now. I feel blessed. My family feel blessed and excited they gave me the opportunity.
What was your draft scene like? I mean, everybody talks about how it's the biggest moment of a young man's life going into the NFL. How was your experience?
It was smooth. Just me and my parents and my brothers and my sisters, my girl cousins that are like sisters to me. So we just all were just hanging out, just us, and then just waiting for that phone call.
Without that group, Marlon, that group of support, the people who've loved you all these years, do you think you'd be in this position?
No, sir. First off, I just want to thank God. I'm very religious, come from a very religious family, and they taught me to always put God first. And without our Lord and then my family, I wouldn't be here today.
I read a lot about you, and you didn't start playing football until high school. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. That's correct.
So why not until high school? What got you into the game, and what were you doing before that?
I was just playing on the streets at the park, you know, just being a little kid. And the only opportunity I got to play football was once I got to high school, just because of the funds and everything like that. But once I started playing football, I knew that I fell in love with the game. A goal of mine was to reach the NFL, and I'm blessed to be here.
It's interesting. You know, some guys, they go for the glory of the game. They want to catch the touchdowns. They want to throw the touchdown. They want to run the football. Did any of that stuff ever, I know you're a bigger guy, did it ever interest you?
Yeah, for sure. When I first started playing, I told my brothers that I wanted to play tight end, and they just looked at me and just kind of started laughing because I was too big for the position. So I was automatically on the offensive line and the defensive line. So. Yeah.
But hey, listen, I think that the offensive linemen and the defensive linemen, would you agree, are among the very best athletes on the football field? I mean, you've got to do a lot of things. It's not just because you're a big guy that you play alone. You got to have good feet. You've got to have range. You've got to have leverage. Would you agree with me on that?
For sure. I've heard this since I was in high school. Just building a championship team, you got to have like guys in the trenches. Like that's where the heart of the team is. So for sure, I agree with you.
You know, your career also includes a state championship as a wrestler in high school. Tell me about your technique as a wrestler, and then tell me how that helped you in the game of football.
The only reason I did wrestling was to help me with football. So just understanding the body and how to maneuver it certain ways to your advantage, using your hands, and then like creating violent hands, and then understanding leverage as well. So all those things for sure helped me become a better football player.
Marlon, I know you were a highly recruited player coming out of high school, and you chose Washington first, I think, and then you eventually decided on USC. What was the experience like playing for Southern California?
It was a dream come true. I was raised in Southern California, so growing up, I was always watching USC football, watching Reggie Bush and Matt Leiner and them winning national championships. And that was a goal of mine as a little kid, just to one day shoot up for the Trojans, and luckily it happened.
Now you come into the NFL, you're going to join an Eagles defensive line room that includes Fletcher and Javon Hargrave and others. But Fletcher, I mean, one of the greatest defensive lineman in the history of the game here. Have you watched a lot of him since you've been drafted? Have you even gone and kind of studied Fletcher at all? And what's it gonna be like to be in the same room and kind of be a sponge to him and the veterans?
Exactly what you said. I wanna be a sponge to those older guys. I understand that they're gonna for sure help me with my game as well. So I'm just excited to learn from them. And I watched Fletcher a little bit in college as well, just showing like how much power he has and how he uses his leverage as well and his nonstop violent hands to an advantage. So. Like, that's something I definitely want to learn from him and also Hargrave as well.
Marlon, I know academics, you know, you're shined as a student. Why have academics been a big part of your life? Is that something that your parents instilled in you from the get-go?
They for sure told me that school was something that I should take seriously because without that, football wouldn't be here. So continuing to just stay disciplined in that aspect as well, it for sure helped me ease things when I got on the field as well.
So what is your mindset now? We're getting into the rookie camp. You're going to be in Philadelphia for a couple of weeks. You're going to be in your professional life. What kind of mindset do you have?
I just want to go in there and work and be a sponge. understanding that I'm a rookie coming in, I just want to show the organization that I'm definitely a hard worker, and I want to go in there and learn and understand my role once I get in there.
You sound like a very humble guy. On the field, are you a nice guy or are you a mean guy?
I see myself definitely as a mean guy. I don't say much. I let my play do the talking. So that's something I'm going to continue to do once I get to Philly, for sure.
Last one for you. You're going to come to the NovaCare complex here. Have you kind of envisioned what it's going to be like walking into this building for the first time?
I think it's going to hit me once I land in Philly. Definitely was a dream of mine, and it's coming true. So once I hit that facility, I'm definitely going to be a starstruck for sure.